Welcome to CaneAndRinse.com. This is a credit screen, and not just any old credit screen. This is one with a Brad Galloway in it. Gone TV? What's going on here? This is a game called Containment, the Zombie Puzzler. I just guessed that name. No, I didn't. Nah, it's called Containment. It's on Steam for £2.99. That's £2.99. Some guy that looks like Huck. I don't know what's going on. There's esports references. There's StarCraft references. There's GOM TV, the people who host GSL. I don't know what relationship they have. Tastosis, what is going on in this game? Uber Entertainment, what's going on? These are names that I like. And this is a puzzle game where you sort of contain zombies. I know it's in the title here, the Containment, the Zombie Puzzler. It's weird. It's good and it's weird. Let's have a look. I played a few levels already just to get used to the idea of what the game is. It's kind of like a match three, but it's not. Let me show you. So we've got these different types of zombie combatants here. We have the pink nurses, the soldiers, the cops, and there's a punk there. And every time you contain a zombie using these types of zombie combatants, you will unlock a weapon, and that can help you fight the zombies off in different ways. So we got three green guys around this middle guy here, this zombie with purple eyes. I've never seen him before, he just cropped up at the end of a cutscene. But I'm going to try and do what I did before with normal zombies and contain him. So what I do, I left click the green one, and I replace it, or I swap it with the blue cop. Okay, so as you saw there, it shot the zombie, and it sort of turned him into a different form, which so we need some cops basically. So let's do this, this, and this, and they contain him, and then the zombie dies. And this is like the theme of the game so far. Like, it goes from location to location as a bird's eye view, and it tells you a little story in between each puzzle section, which I quite like, to be honest. It reminds me of Bejeweled, when it used to go level complete, and it used to go down like some sort of time warp zone, and not the song. Let's do the time up. No, yeah, it reminds me of that. So there's no like going back to the main menu and jumping back into a level and then making you feel really like disjointed with the level series progresses. It keeps you in the game, which I quite like. So we have this big guy in the middle, which I think we need to take out first. So let's contain him. I did that wrong, but there we go. It'll turn into a red guy. But what we need to keep our eyes out on is these other zombies can attack the humans on the map. So we need to eradicate them as quick as possible, or else they get turned into a zombie. And before you know it, as like all zombie things, you will get overrun and you cannot fight back. I'm not terribly good at the game, to be honest. See, like, as we heard there, someone's in trouble. Who was that? Ah, this guy here. So what we need to do, we need to get the yellows around him as soon as possible and wrap him right up. As we've got here, we've got three. How do you contain three? Well, you need to get every piece of surface area covered so you can kill them off. It took me a little while to work that one out because the game doesn't really tell you explicitly how to contain a group. Oh, look, he's coming in from the side. What's going on? Oh, I need to speed up, don't I? Contained. I think it's the amount of time, not the amount of turns, that dictates when a zombie's going to attack a human. I think it's time, so it's all about time is of the essence, is what they say. Okay, let's click on this. Yeah! And the items up here at the top, and if I press the one key, I can then use an item somewhere. You can't really change the direction, which is like a compromise. You can't bend it to your will, so you will have to take out one human. But it's for the greater good of killing two zombies. And we knock it down, and we get on with our apocalypse-filled life. Oh dear, I'm not very good at this. Oh no, he's going to get turned into a zombie. This game is also on the iPad. From what I could tell, I think it would suit the iPad better than a PC. It's good playing it on the PC, don't get me wrong, but I think this game's made for touchscreen. Yeah! Oh, hang on. Right, let's get this lightning bolt. Let's overkill it, eh? Why not? Get him there. And then him. Oh, no. I need to click on there again. No! I feel your pain. Right, I'm missing something. There we go. Boom. Contained. No matter how many we took down, they never stopped coming. Yeah, they're coming in from this. And because I use the cop, I get free sniper bullets to use on zombies. So there's grenades, there's Molotov, there's electricity, there's sniper rifle rounds, and yeah, it's a nice little reward for using a specific type of soldier or, you know, cop or whatever. Man, need to get a load of pinkies. Come here. And yeah, it's all very basic controls, like left click to oh, random. What's this? That's a zombie. Oh. Uh-oh, they're spreading fast. Quick, let's contain them, because that's what the game's called. Yeah, screw you, zombie. Yes, yeah, so it's all left click to move. If you make a wrong move, like if you left click on the wrong colour, you can also just left click it again to deselect it. And yeah, the 1-2-3 keys are just the 1-2-3 on your keyboard. It's as simple as. What is this? Is that a missile? Oh my god, that's gonna. Oh my god. That was just overkill. I'm sorry for. Oh no, what have I done? I don't know if that's good or bad. And like, oh, nope, he's dead. There's a lot of these interactions with the environment. It's all just a matter of a left click, which is fine by me. You don't have to do anything extravagant. It looks like your items carry over to the next sort of round. Yeah, and it's just a quite nice idea on the puzzle genre. Well, what with it being a 2.5D camera, I'm wondering if it'd look better on a, not better, but you know, like if the 3D effect would look good on the 3DS, because as everyone knows, the 3DS shines when the 3D effect is on a 2.5D camera. Oh god. Okay, they're piling it on thick and fast now. Where's my micro when I need it? I need to take my StarCraft lessons into this game. There we go, got grenades. So I might as well just pop him with a grenade. Not really bothered about the... Oh, hey, there's a guy in the middle. Let's do this on him. What was that? Ah. Oh. Overkill, just because it's fun. Yeah. I think earlier when I played the game, I dropped a safe on someone, which is quite entertaining. Zombies. Right, we need to take this guy down first, I guess. See, he's a big one.
Help me!
I was in the zone then. God, you couldn't stop me, even if you had a billion zombies. Yeah, it just seems to carry on like this. I haven't really seen much in the way of variety, but you know, it's a small indie game for $2.99 on either platform, PC or iPad. Hello, what's this? This fence blocks reinforcements. Okay, so I take it I can knock down the fence. So I'm gonna need reinforcements. Surround the generators, then open the gate. I see. Okay, this is a nice little twist. So if I did this, is it gonna? Is there only one more? I guess I need one around the other side as well. Alright. Trying to open a gate here. So selfish. Oh man, I'm just wrecking fools. Yes, please. I've got Molly. Just for fun. All right. Yeah, and this is a containment. The zombie puzzler. It's exactly what it says on the tin. Look, bit of blood there. Blop. Yeah, we've got different modes. Survival mode. It's exactly how it sounds. Survive those amount of blocks in a, you know, like, in by blocks they mean like streets. It's the American term for block. No, it's not. And yeah, it's got leaderboards and achievements and stuff like that. It's a nice little platform game. I mean, platform game. It's a nice little puzzle game that, I don't know, like, you know, zombie games are always hoarding out of the doorway like a zombie horde would, and it's nice to see something that isn't completely generic like a twin stick shooter. Oh, zombies of twin stick shooter, you know, I mean, it's nice to see that, you know, that they've taken a puzzle game genre which is like basically match three and they've added their own little spin to it, and I quite enjoy it with the zombie element. And yeah, you can grab it now. It's about £3. I would prefer it on the iPad, but I haven't got loads of money to spend on an iPad, so I wonder if it's on the Android. That'd be nice. Or iPhone. Yeah, so if you're interested in a zombie puzzler, you can grab it like a zombie would grab you. Bye. Yeah, I've been Darren Guckett. I forgot to do that bit. And this has been a quick rinse for kananrinse.com. Thanks for watching.